quarantine to always being on the scene. CeeLaw Productions Incorporated has birthed CeeLaw Spot, and it is hot, hot, hot. Flaming hot with the Holy Ghost fire, as Minister Javon Ophelia Butler brings the word from the four winds of God of the third dimension, the place where God lives, pulling down the kavod, God's Shekinah glory. Introducing CeeLaw Spot, the virtual view, God's view about you, boxing the devil through prayer. Prayer is your only weapon. God's mercies renew every morning. Join us for fire, straight down from heaven, as we go to war through prayer with CeeLaw Serenity Prayer Line with Minister Javon Ophelia Butler. Dial in at 857-347-0610 or stream live from CeeLaw Serenity Prayer Line on Facebook. For prayer requests, send your email to CeeLawPrayerLine@gmail.com. Moving the nations through prayer and CeeLaw Spot, the virtual view. Catch the wave and join the movement. Like us now.
All things, Romans 8:28. For your good, harden not your heart, and allow your heart to say yes to the spirit of obedience. The Lord is calling his nation down to its knees. Stop praying, heal the land, and ask God to heal you so that you can heal the land. God bless you.
Fresh wind blowing this room. Fresh wind blowing this room. Fresh wind blowing this room. Holy Ghost fire.
Oh God, I bless you, oh God, upon, oh God, this anointed day. Oh God, I praise you, oh God, oh God, for this appointed day. Oh God, for this is the day, oh God, that you have made. Oh God, and I shall rejoice, and we shall rejoice, and be glad in it. Oh God, great is thy faithfulness, oh God, and great is thy grace. Oh God, thy grace and thy mercies, my God, has carried us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And for that, oh God, I say thank you. Oh, tell the Lord thank you, my God, for 2 Corinthians 12:9 says, that his grace is sufficient. Oh God, your grace is sufficient, oh God, for the people, oh God, that's all over the world, for everyone, oh God, that's breathing under the sound of my voice. Welcome to CeeLaw Serenity Prayer Line. This is midday manna. Oh God, I thank you, oh God, for the fresh manna, oh God, that you are dropping, oh God, out of the heavens upon this day. God says he wants you to know that he is a Jeremiah 33:3 God. The Lord said, call unto me, and I shall answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things in which you do not know. God is calling us to trust, my God, upon this midday, my God, manna. Remember that midday manna, my God, it's not about 12 noon. Am I right about it? Midday manna, my God, it's about God meeting you in the middle of your situation. That means if you are in the middle, that means you are almost to the end. So the Lord wants us to know on this prayer, my God, that when we call unto him, my God, he shall answer us. Am I right about it? He will show us great and mighty things, my God, in which we do not know. I hear the Lord say to keep the faith. The Lord says it's not what you see, but the Lord says it's what I have said. The Lord says my grace, it is sufficient for you. God says my grace is sufficient, my God. He says my grace is amazing. The Lord says amazing grace, my God. How sweet the sound, my God. God says my grace, it is sufficient. The Lord says my grace is sufficient for you. God says his grace is sufficient for your health. God says his grace is sufficient for your family. God says his grace is sufficient for your marriage. Come on. God says my grace is sufficient, my God, for your money in the name of Jesus, I cancel every spirit of lack of the persons that's listening under the sound of my voice. I pray for the west wind, my God, to hit you like fire in the name of Jesus. That God will put you, my God, in an overwhelming, in an overshock, oh God, upon this day in the name of Jesus. That the west wind, my God, it will blow in the things that you will need, the resources that you will need, in the mighty name of Jesus. I hear the Lord saying again, my God, he says, my grace is sufficient. God says, my grace fights your enemies, my God. Isaiah 54:17, he says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper in the name of Jesus. God says, every tongue that rises up against you, my God, in judgment, God says, you condemn them right now in the name of Jesus. God says, my grace has given you a space, my God, a grace. God says, space, my God, a space of grace, God says, he has given you in the name of Jesus. God says, do not be heavy trodden, my God. God says, don't hang your neck low. God says, pick your head up, my God. God says, pick your head up, my God. I hear all ye gates. Oh, God, all ye gates. God says, I've called you a gate, my God. The everlasting Father, my God. Jeremiah 31:3 says that the Lord has loved us with an everlasting love. God says, I love you despite of you, my God. God says, I love you despite of you. God says, my grace have been sufficient. God says, my grace is sufficient for your life. God says, my grace is sufficient for your understanding. God says, my grace, God says, my grace, have carried you, my God, in the mighty name of Jesus. I could hardly get this prayer out. God wants you to know that he has saved you by grace, my God. God says, I've saved you from yourself, my God. By grace, God says, grace and mercy, my God. God says, grace and mercy. The great twins, the Lord says, I have delivered unto you. God says, I've delivered it already. God says, I've answered your prayer, my God. Psalms 81:7 says that the psalmist cried out in distress, and God answered him, my God, out of a thunderclouds. God says, he wants you to know on today, my God, if you don't know anything else from this prayer, God says, my grace is sufficient for you. God bless you.
God is here.
AI.
Hello. My God from Zion, I'm telling you, that prayer, when I do that, it means, you know, the media team, you know, to bring it down. Amen. God's blessings to everyone on this wonderful, wonderful, wonderful broadcast. I'm telling you, of course, we come on every Thursday Eve. I'm telling you, and for some of my people that's in Africa, my God, and all of the other foreign countries all over the world, I get a lot of inboxes, amen, and I'm telling you, I thank God for the people that support Selah Spot, the virtual view, amen. You know, I'm always looking from monitor to monitor, amen. I hope that you are well and doing well, amen. God's blessings to everyone. I don't know, I got a smile on my face. It's stuck. Amen. How many people know you can have a Kool-Aid smile? Am I right about it? God is so wonderful. He's so wonderful, and he's worthy to be praised. Amen. I want you to give the Lord a hand clap wherever you are. I want you to clap, 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 clap. I'm telling you, God likes when we praise. Am I right about it? The Lord enjoys the praises of his people. Am I right about it? I'm telling you, God is wonderful. I'm smiling. I'm telling you, I'm some tickle inside. Amen. God is wonderful. That is the joy of the Lord. That's the joy of the Lord. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Am I right about it? Oh, God's blessing to you. I was tickle pink like my lipstick. I'm telling you, when God said I could come back on another time, because normally when I record something new, the pattern has been, I stay off for about 3 weeks and then I come back on. Somebody say something new. Come on. God is doing something new in this season, and I want you to catch it. I want you to grab hold to it. Am I right about it? God is wonderful. I'm telling you, God's blessings to everyone that's chiming in. I'm telling you, the people that come on, like Carnance and all of the people that like to come on the broadcast, God's blessings to all of you. I'm telling you, even people like Dr. Dickerson and her mom that watches, I'm telling you, God's blessings to that family. This is a wonderful time to serve God. I just heard the Lord say that. This is a wonderful year. It's almost like I heard him talking when he's giving me downloads during the new year. He just said, my God, this is good. He says, it's a wonderful year, 2024. I'm telling you, God wants you to know that you will have more. You will have more. I know some of you guys have not seen it. Some of you are starting to see it. Come on. God says it springs forth. Come on. It's springing forth. Isaiah 43:19, I'm telling you, and God says that it's a wonderful year. So this is a new beginning for a lot of you that's coming on to watch me on tonight. I remember I said that last week, that it was going to be something new. I know the seed that was sown, what was it was a $53 seed, I'm telling you. Now see, God is something. He told me I could go ahead and say it. I'm saying at the beginning of the broadcast, the seed today is 35. He flipped it. I'm telling you, he was talking about newness on the last broadcast, and he let me come right back on consecutively on this broadcast, and today's seed is 35, which equals 8. It's the number of 8. Am I right about it? Some of you guys are getting ready to embark upon something beautiful, I just heard the Lord say. Some things that you've been waiting for, some things you haven't been waiting for. God is getting ready to do it. Isn't that exciting? That's very exciting. I'm telling you, little things try to come into my proximity. I'm telling you, to make me feel this or that or that or this way. Come on. And it just, whoop, water off my back. It don't even bother me. Somebody said maturity. You got to be mature. When God starts to mature you in your calling, in the things that he's called you to, the things that used to bother you, it don't bother you anymore. Because you are, my God, I feel the glory. Because you feel the goodness of God. I'm telling you, it's like God, you know, he gives you a glory shot. His glory. Am I right about it? You know how we want God to give us a speed shot? God will give you a glory shot. It refreshes you. Am I right about it? Come on. I'm telling you. I'm being animated on tonight. I hope that made somebody laugh. If that was funny to you, you can go ahead and put a laugh in the face in the prompt. It's okay. I'm telling you, God's blessings. I'm not calling names like I normally do. Sometimes God commands me, my God, not to call names. Come on, because God wants to keep us humble and low. God appreciates you coming on. Am I right about it? Because when I sit here, I'm an oracle of him. It's none of me. It's all of him. And God said, on tonight and on this early morning, and for some of you it's noonday, God said he's giving you a glory shot. Gotta catch it and put it all over yourself. Amen. I'm telling you, God is wonderful. God is wonderful. The breathing of the ruach of the neshama of God, come on, it'll refresh your spirit. Come on, it will refresh your soul. I'm telling you, God knows how to refresh your spirit. He knows how to refresh your soul. Those that are, I hear the Lord say, come on, those that are heavy laden, my God. Jesus said that, what? He says, I will give you rest, my God, for your soul. Come on, come on, come on. Jesus says, I will give you rest, my God, from Zion. Those that are heavy laden, come on, come on, come on. Jesus, he says, come unto me, all who are weary and burdened. And he says, I will give you rest. In Matthew 11:28, he says, come to me. You got to know how to go to God. Come on, we're going to talk about it on tonight. That's not the subject, but I feel the burden of God's people, the tiredness of God's people, the heaviness. Come on, I rebuke the spirit of heaviness off of your life. Come on, I want to come as a breath of fresh glory to you. Come on, come on. Got to catch it and you got to let that glory fall on you. My God, I felt the glory. If you didn't feel it, I felt it for myself. Amen. You got to let God shine with a rain on you. Come on. the spiritual realm. The spiritual realm. Come on. The fourth dimension. Come on. Where God is. Y'all always hear me talking about the third dimension. But my God, there's another dimension of God. My God. The fourth dimension. Come on. Everybody say you live, you live, you live long, you'll learn long. Come on. I like that. If you live long, you'll learn long. And God has revealed to me, I'm in the fourth dimension. I say, God, my God from Zion. And the third dimension is where the wars happen with the angels and the demons. Come on. Woo! That's why I'm a prayer warrior. When I pray from the third dimension. Come on, because God has made me a warrior. But God let me know. He says, I'm in the fourth dimension. Come on. In that dimension of God, there is peace. There's serenity. There's glory. The glory that God is talking about. That glory shot. Come on. That's coming out the fourth dimension. Somebody say four. Four is the number of increase. God says, I want to increase your faith. Come on. I'm coming to talk to you on this broadcast. And God says, all that are weary and heavy laden, God says, come unto me. He says, I will give you rest. The things that you're concerned about, the things that you're worried about, come on. The bills that you need to pay, come on. Come on. God is with you. God is with you. God is with me. Am I right about it? The Lord says he wants us to trust him. My God, Proverbs 3:5. He says, trust in the Lord with all of your heart, not with some of your heart. You got to trust in the Lord with all of your heart. And the big part, we make a mistake with this. We like to lean to our own understanding because we want to believe what our eyes see. But God says, it's not what you see, it's what I said. So if it's what God said, you got to trust in the Lord with all of your heart. And you can't lean to your own understanding. I mean, you have to ignore the things that you see. You got to, in your heart, you got to believe what God has said. Am I right about it? He says, and acknowledge him in what? In all of our ways. Come on, come on, come on, come on. That's Proverbs 3:5. He says, acknowledge me in all of your ways. Come on, come on, come on. And God says, I will direct your path. Those that's waiting on God to move. Come on, come on. God says, I will direct your path. God says, I'm doing the direction. My God, I like the way the New International Version says. That's why I looked it up. He says, in all your ways, submit to him. You got to surrender all. You got to surrender all in the Baptist church. My God, I was Baptist for 38 years. Am I right about it? I'm not that old. Now, come on. But I was Baptist, come on, for 38 years. And I'm telling you, I remember that song. I surrender all to Jesus. Christ, my Savior, I surrender. Come on. People say, now, Minister Javon, you know how to sing. I don't want to sing it right because it's not about you hearing my melody. I want you to listen to the words. It says, I surrender it all. Those old people, let me tell you, they didn't understand everything, but they understood what they were singing. See, we just sing now for entertainment and lights and fog and all that. No, no, no. When you sing, come on. Hymns in your heart. Come on, come on, come on. My God from Zion. When you sing with hymns in your heart, you have to understand and know what you are saying. My God from Zion. I want you to catch it. My God, I like that. I love that scripture in Jude 20. It says, but ye beloved, building up yourselves in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. Am I right about it? We got to build ourselves up. I mean, look, Psalms 98 says, sing unto the Lord a new, there goes that word, a new song. Come on, come on. You got to build yourself up. I feel people tired. I feel people tired. I feel people tired of waiting. Come on. I feel people tired of the wait, W-E-H-I-G-H-T, of the wait, W-A-I-T. Come on, but God says, I'm on the scene. God says, I'm on the scene. Am I right about it? I want you to make sure that the sound is right. Come back. I want you to make sure that the sound is right. The sound just came in my spirit. God says the weight of the weight. The weight of the weight. Come on, am I right about it? Oh, I want you to catch it. I want you to catch it real good. I'm telling you, God says, don't get tired. God says, don't get tired. There's a song, the Baptist spirit is on me. He says, I've been running for Jesus a long time. And I'm not tired yet. Come on, let's direct the choir. I've been running for Jesus a long time, and I'm not tired yet. Come on now. Come on. I hope that makes somebody smile. I'm telling you, the glory of the Lord. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Come on. I saw the songs in my spirit. Follow me. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Come on. Seeping in. Come on. God says his glory is a glory shot. Every time I do it, I feel it. Come on. I want you to feel it. Come on, God is cleansing us. Before we go into the lesson, come on, God is cleansing us. He's refreshing us. He's reviving us. He's restoring us. He's renewing us for the new. Come on. Oh, I want you to catch it. God got a sweet, sweet spirit on the set. Ooh, it's so sweet. I'm telling you, it's a sweet, sweet spirit. Oh, God is so wonderful. And he loves us. He loves us. Isn't that something? God loves his people. He loves us with an everlasting love. Oh, God. He sees you in the night hour when you're laying up by yourself, having thoughts and trying to understand what the Spirit of the Lord is saying concerning your life. And God says, trust him. Trust him with everything, I hear him saying. He says, tell them to trust me with everything. God says, don't trust him with just some things. God says, trust him with everything. The spirit is so sweet. On his set, I don't even want to move. I'm trying to stay. I want to stay where he is. Am I right about it? My God, here comes the glory of the Lord. Come on. Come on, come on. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Sweeping in the room. Come on. Hey, God, help it. But say it one more time. Here comes the glory of the Lord. God says, here comes the glory. Come on. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Sweeping in the room. Oh, I want you to catch it. Come on. God says, his glory is sweeping on his set. My God, I can feel. I feel like I want to cry right now. Come on. If he don't move, I'm not moving. Jesus. God says he wants us to sing in our spirit. Come on. We got to let the Holy Spirit sing hymns and songs in our spirit. God wants us to know his glory is resting upon the earth. And he wants his glory to rest upon you. My God, but we have to be a certain way. Yes, we saved by grace. We saved by grace to run the race. But God says, I'm talking about obedience. Come on. Oh, there it is. He said, I'm talking about obedience. He says, I'm talking about obedience. He says, the obedience of you will cleanse your atmospheric all around you. Your obedience will save your family. Come on, am I right about it? My God from Zion. My God from Zion. My God from Zion. God says, your obedience. If God wanted to do something in a nation, he would use one person. Am I right about it? Oh, God, it says that. It says that it was by a prophet. Come on, that the children of Israel was delivered from out of Egypt. Oh, glory, my God. God says it. God says, when I want to do something, I'll use one person. But God says, I need to cleanse everything around you. See, he doesn't want me to go into the lesson because he don't want you to listen to me saying. Come on. He wants you to listen to me glad because God says that you cannot bring the old into the new. You can't bring it. You can't bring old people into the new that don't belong. You can't bring old ideas into the new. If God's getting ready to give you a new car, come on. You can't treat it like the old car. Am I right about it? If God is getting ready to give you something new, you got to let the new stay with the new. Come on. What did Jesus say? You can't pour old wineskins. Come on. You can't pour old wineskins into the new wineskin. Am I right about it? Because it will break. It will burst. God says when if you try to pour something old into something new, it's going to burst. That means it's going to be confusion. It's not going to work. It's going to be destroyed. God says the new is you. See, this is carrying into something different. God says the new is you. That's something he gives me around New Year's. He says the new is you. The new is the new. I hear him say the new is the new fruition of you. Jesus. That means God is rising you up. God says, I'm rising them up so they will never come down. Ooh. He says, I'm rising them up so that they will never come down. Yeah. What do you tell John in Revelation? He says, come up hither. Through the angel, he says, come up hither. God says he wants you to come up. He wants you to come up so that you don't come down. God wants the seed of yourself planted inside of him. The seed of you, the good soil, Luke 8. Am I right about it? God says, if you plant yourself inside of him, he's good ground. And God says, if you plant yourself inside of him, you will yield a good harvest. That you will yield the crops of the harvest. Am I right about it? He says, I am the Lord of the harvest. Come on. Oh, I want you to catch it. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Come on. My God is in my spirit. Here comes the glory of the Lord. When the glory of the Lord comes to seep in any place, that means that whole place is about to shift. I want you to be sure. If you're watching me, you're getting ready to shift. Come on. If you're around me, you're getting ready to shift. Come on. Come on. I've been talking to my sister lady. It's getting ready to happen. Come on. God, Jesus, God says, I'm getting ready to do not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit. Zechariah 4:6. Come on. We got to get ready for the glory. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Come on. God says the glory is getting ready to shine in your life. The Shekinah glory. The glory that brings in the yes. Come on. The glory that brings in the yes from the test. Am I right about it? Oh, God. God is sitting on his chest. So wonderful. It's a sweet, sweet spirit. Jesus. It wasn't the same lay of him when I first sat down. He came in when I start singing. Come on. Come on, the angels are entertaining the atmosphere where I am. And God says, I'm trying to seep into your house. I'm trying to seep into your car. I'm trying to seep into your bedroom. He said, I'm trying to seep into wherever you are, your living room, your quarters. I heard the Lord say, your apartment, my God, your condo. God says, I'm trying to seep. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Seeping in the room, wherever you are. Oh, my God. Come on. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Come on. God wants you to know his glory is coming for you. That's why he says, come to me, all who are heavy and laden. Come on. Downtrodden. God says, I will give you rest. Here comes the glory of the Lord. When the glory comes, rest comes. Am I right about it? What did he tell Moses in the 33rd chapter of Exodus? He says, my presence will go before you. Come on. He says, and then I will give you rest. When God's glory, when his presence comes before him, come on, after he leaves, come on. The residue of the kabod and the kavod and rest, the cloud of glory. God, come on. And God says, guess when you start to rest? Oh, when the clouds clear, come on, God, and the clarity come, come on. God says, that's when I will give you rest. See, some of you are cloudy right now. Am I right about it? Come on, because the cloud is resting upon you. But God says, I'm getting ready to give you a Sabbath rest. Those that are watching me, the Lord says, I'm getting ready to give you a Sabbath rest. Even though you didn't pass the test. Come on, grace. He says, my grace and my mercy have met you on this. Jesus, he says, my grace and my mercy has met you on this set. I surrender all. Come on. I surrender all. Come on. All to Jesus Christ, my Savior. I surrender all. My God, my mother used to sing that. Oh, how I miss her. It's getting ready to be 5 years this upcoming June. Come on. I miss her. She used to sing that through the house. She would sing it at church. I surrender all. What was she saying? She said, she was saying, God, I surrender myself to you. My mother died on June 11th. She passed away at a time that equal 11. I'm not giving the time. God is withholding that. She was in a room that equals the number 11. Am I right about it? Come on. 11 is the number of transition and switch. And God says, I'm getting ready to shift and switch some of you into your new. Oh, I want you to catch it. The Lord says that your new is the new part of you. God says that your new is the new part of you. Isaiah 54 and 17. No weapon, no person, no people, no group. My God, no job, no friends, no husband, no church group, no spouse, no cousin, no mother, no brother, no daddy, no auntie. Come on. No uncle will be able to stop the glory that's getting ready to come to your life. The Lord says that some of you that's listening to me, you've already paid the price. Come on. And you are getting ready to enter into your new season. The land that's flowing, hey, with milk and honey. Oh, I want you to catch it. Here it comes. The glory of the Lord. Come on. Come on. You got to sing it with me. Here comes the glory of the Lord. And it's seeping in. The room is already resting. I rebuke every demonic demon that would try to stop the glory from resting in your life. God says the testing is over for some of you. Come on. Oh, he says for all of you that's watching. I mean, if you watch this set on a Saturday morning at 8 o'clock, if you watch me on Sunday, come on, at 12 noon, if you watch it in a pop-up, if you watch it on a Sunday night, God says your test is over. The testing is over. God says the test has given you rest. Why did the test give you rest? Because of your obedience. What is the name of this segment? My God, it's a well-rooted rap. Oh, my God. My God. A well-rooted rap. I want you to put that up for me. Come on. A well-rooted rap. My God, from Zion. That's why when the Lord was talking about being a seed, my God, I got it now. I was wondering where he was going with that. That's when God was talking about a seed. Am I right about it? He was talking about how we are to plant ourselves inside of him, that we would yield the kind of harvest that Luke, the 8th chapter, talks about when it talks about the four souls and four soils. Am I right about it? But the fourth soil, come on, my God, from Zion. The fourth soil is the good soil. My God, from Zion. And when he talks about the soil, let me pull it up, my God, from Zion. When he talks about the soil, he talks about my favorite soil is the good soil. Am I right about it? And he talks about the soils. Here it is. He talks about the soil. He talks about the farmer. The farmer that was that went out to sow his seed. Come on. And it was, and as he scattered the seed and it fell along the path. Am I right about it? And some was trampled on. Come on, come on, come on. And some of the birds eat up that particular seed, and then some fell on the rocky ground. Come on, follow me. I know it in my heart, but I want to read it because I'm counting them. Am I right about it? And then he talks about how the rocky ground happened and how the plants had withered, you know, and it didn't happen because it didn't have any moisture. Come on, come on. It didn't have any capacity to believe. The people that those seeds fell on, and it fell upon the thorns. Am I right about it? Yes, that's right. And it was choked up. It grew with other things with it. My God. But still, the other seed, the fourth seed. Somebody said four. I just talked about four being the number of increase that God lives in the fourth dimension. God says that seed was planted in good soil, and it yielded a crop 100 times more than what it was sown. When you sow your $35 seed on this broadcast, you will be seeded into a word, my God, that will bring the new unto you. Oh, God. He is telling me a well-rooted rap, dot, 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 the new unto you. My God, that's the new title. The new unto you. God says, I'm trying to get the new unto you. That's why we had to go through us feeling some kind of way. We had to let the The glory shot hit us. Am I right about it? We like to have to let the songs bring back our remembrance so that we could be happy to know that we have to surrender it all. And that the glory of the Lord is moving. Come on. It's entering into our spaces. Am I right about it? And the Shekinah glory, it brings a refreshing. It brings the spirit of restoration. Come on. And God talked about Proverbs, and he wants you to know to trust in him. Doesn't matter what you see, is what you believe. Because what you believe activates the faith. Hebrews 11:6 says that it's impossible to please God without faith. He that cometh to God must first believe, my God, that he is a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. Not seek him on Saturday and go back on next Wednesday. Come on. You got to seek him Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, love. Y'all know that song? You got to love God. Because I told you earlier, Jeremiah 31:3, he has loved us with an everlasting love. Oh, I want you to catch it. I told you, you got to build yourself in your most holy faith. Jude 20, come on. You got to build yourself in your most holy, praying in the Holy Spirit. You got to spend time praying in your heavenly language. You have to have a praying spirit. You got to pray all day long in your spirit. You got to remember to tell God, thank you for that parking lot. God, thank you for the healing of my body months ago. Come on. God, thank you for making a way out of no way. Thank you, God, that the word, oh God, it flows out of my belly. Thank you, God, that I have a job. Thank you, God, that I married the right person. Come on, come on. Thank you, God, that you are in the middle of my marriage. Come on, come on. Y'all know that song, Moni in the Middle, where she at? I don't know why it's in my spirit, but God is in the middle of everything. Am I right about it? My sister said, come on. God is in the middle. That's why when I pray midday manner, come on. When I pray midday manner, y'all see that? See, put the flyer. When I do midday manner, it's not the middle. It's not for 12 noon. That's God meeting you in the middle of your situation. I'm on the side so that the flyer can pop up. My God, I want you to catch it. Come on. God says, I'm in the middle of everything. That's why you have to be a well-rooted rap. See that flyer? Don't miss. How you do it? Don't miss midday manner. That's not a 12 noon prayer. That's God giving me fresh manner to pray for you in the middle of your situation. That's why it's called midday manner. That means if you are midday, that means you are midway to the blessing. See, everything don't always have to mean what you think it means. Come on. That's why God, before I pray, he had me to say that. I'm not a replica of anything. I'm a replica of God in everything. Oh, I like that. I'm not a replica of anything. But I'm a replica of God in anything, in everything. Let's say it again. I'm not a replica of God in anything. I'm a replica of God in everything. Everything about me is him. And midday manner is fresh manner coming from heaven, meeting you in the middle of your situation. Anytime you see that fly and you hear that prayer, it will bless you. It's a prophetic manner, fresh from heaven. You could take it down. My God. My God. That song is in my spirit. It's in my spirit, my God. Here comes the glory of the Lord. That means God wants you to know I'm coming. He's even already there. But he wants you to know I'm coming to see about you. Those that are concerned. God, he says, tell my people. I hear him so clear in my spirit. He says, let them know I'm coming to see about them. A well-rooted rap. How can I be well-rooted? A root. What is a root? What is a root? A root is a part of a plant which attaches it to the ground or to a support. It's typically underground, conveying water and nourishment to the rest of the plant via numerous branches or fibers. I like that definition. Let me break it down. It says that a root is a part of a plant which attaches it to the ground. That means you are a root. Am I right about it? And you attach yourself to the Father. Come on. And it also says, or to a support. Isn't our Father our support? Don't he provide every one of our needs? Through Philippians 4:19, according to his riches and his glory. And it says it's typically underground. My God from Zion. Aren't we under the auspice and the authority under God's rulership? Come on, come on. Am I right about it? And it says conveying water, which is a representation of the Holy Spirit. Jesus, my God. And the nourishment, my God, the Holy Spirit is likened unto Jesus in the earth realm. When Jesus ascended to heaven, he says that my helper, that we are sending, I'm sending a helper, which is the Holy Spirit, which is the triune, the third of the triune God, the triune of Jehovah, the Godhead, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is likened unto the water. The Holy Spirit is our guidance. He's our helper. He conveys help to us in the earth realm, so that we can be rulers, my God, over the enemy, so that we can destroy the devil and all of his attacks against our lives. He is like a nourishment. He's a water. He's a representation of freshness. He's a representation of liquidated. My God, he's a representation of wetness. Come on, am I right about it? And he gives us nourishment. How does he give us nourishment? Because those that have accepted Jesus as their personal savior, the Holy Spirit is a gifting that God gives to you. That when you say, oh, my conscience told me. No, no, no. The Holy Spirit told you, don't leave at 5, but leave at 6. Come on. Or don't leave at 6, but leave at 8. Come on. That's the Holy Spirit. What is he doing? He is nourishing you. He's protecting you. He's nourishing you. When you read the Bible, come on, and you get in trouble, and it's the Holy Spirit that brings back the scriptures to your memory, your remembrance. Am I right about it? That is a nourishment to your soul as we feed our physical body. My God, when you read the word of God, come on, you feed your spiritual body. When you feed your spiritual body, come on, that's when the Holy Spirit brings back the scriptures as a nourishment to your spirit. Did you catch it? And then it talks about to rest, to the rest of the plant. That means the Holy Spirit gives nourishment to your entire body. Even your physical body benefits from the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit brings and activates. He's the power. Jesus, the Godhead. God gives the commandment. Jesus, he performs the commandment. And the Holy Spirit is the power, the dunamis, that makes the power behind it happen. It wasn't the 5 smooth stones that David had. It wasn't the 5 smooth stones that David had. Am I right about it? It was the power behind the stones that killed Goliath. Oh, I want you to catch it. I want you to catch it. I want you to catch what I'm saying. Am I right about it? God wants us to understand a root. A well-wrapped, a well-rooted wrap. That's the name of this segment. Did you put it up? As I asked you, let's put it up again. A well-rooted wrap. We are in rap sessions. Am I right about it? We are in rap sessions edition. And God wants you to know, he wants you to know to be a well-rooted wrap. How can I be well-rooted? I'm glad you asked me. Obedience. There it is. You can't do anything without obedience. I'm going to talk ebonically. You can't do nothing without obedience. That's why things are not transpiring in your life, because you're skipping the obedience. God trains us in obedience. When I miss a step, everything stops. Am I right about it? Everything around me stopped. I said, God, what is it? And he don't release it till I figure it out. Somebody say, train in obedience. He's training me. He's training me to understand what he wants and what he don't want. He chastises me. He chastises you. But you have to realize that you're being chastised. Oh, that's up right there. God wants that up. You have to realize that you're being chastised. You know, you see how God pampered you in the beginning? We sung? Come on, yes. Oh, hallelujah time. But he wants you to know that he loves you, but he's not playing with you. Some of us don't realize we're being chastised. We make excuses. I've did it before. I've made excuses. I said, well, that happened because I did this, or that happened because I did that. But we have to realize that God allows things to happen in our lives. The devil can touch it, Joel, unless the Lord allows it. So if things are happening to you, you got to ask God, God, why you allowed that to happen to me? I serve you. I do everything you ask me to do to the best of my ability. And you still let that happen? You still let this happen to me? Whatever your happen is. I don't know what your happen is, but you know what your happen is. He said the devil did it. The devil can't do you nothing without God saying, you could do it. Why is the father Adonai? Because he's a master teacher. See, we see God. Oh, geez. Woo! I almost spoke out into my heavenly language just now. Because God liked what I just said. He's like, he loved what I'm getting ready to see. We forget that God allows things to happen to us. We always say the devil, I bind you. No, come on. Y'all know y'all like to say that. Isaiah 54:7. And y'all get a face when y'all know. Come on. But that scripture is for the righteous. Y'all do it with feeling. Come out your belly. No. Come on. And that God be like this at you. Why is he like that? Because it's not a weapon, it's him. Some people don't like that. It's not a weapon, it's him. He wants me to tell people, it's not the devil, it's you and your disobedience. But he says, despite of you, he says, my glory, I think you need to come get this. You can let that person know I'm broadcasting right now. You could call them on the other phone up in here. He wants us to know that it's us. He just said the glory of the Lord is seeping in the room. When the glory of God seeps into a place, the spirit of truth, oh, Jesus, is revealed in that place. Before all of the exposure started happening this year, I told my assistant in the early part of January, I said, God says this is going to be the year of exposure that will cause explosions. Now, I add exposures myself, but God told me, says this is the year of exposure. That means everything is going to come to the light. You can repeat till you're blue in the face. It's coming out. Why is God allowing the things to come out about us? Because he's cleansing you. Some things you can repent for in silence, but some things he allows us to have to repent for publicly for guidance. You can't refute the repentance. Well, I asked God to forgive me. Yeah, you said it, but God likes what he likes. He wants what he wants. So that means if you repented, that you repent the way he wanted you to repent. Some things, if you did it publicly, he wants you to repent publicly. Jesus, that's for somebody. That means your repentance has been rejected. Lord, there's a scripture that says that. There's a scripture that says that. In Psalms 53:5, he says, for God despised them. Go read. Some of the verses says he has rejected them. So when the glory of the Lord comes into the room, it uncovers the things that don't belong, because God himself is a consuming fire. Come on. He's a consuming fire. He's a consuming fire. Deuteronomy 4:24. That's why you have to realize when you're being chastised, If you don't realize you're being chastised, then you won't be able to fix it, because the wisdom and the understanding and the knowledge of God is not there. How can you root yourself in God if you're not ready? Oh, I want you to put that up. The root has to be ready. The root has to be ready. For you to be a well-rooted ramp in God, the root has to be ready. God is not going to bless you any kind of way with you living and acting any kind of way. Your little subtle things and the things that we do, God says, I'm addressing you for the new. He said, not only am I addressing you for the new, he said, I'm dressing you for the new. God says, I'm giving you a new garment. But God says, first we have to make clean. We have to make clean careful. We have to kill the things that do not belong, the people that don't belong. God says, some of you, I've told you to do things a long time ago and you still have not listened. Then you have to question yourself, are you really embedded in God? Are you just embedded in yourself? In order for a root to grow, it has to be nourished by the Holy Spirit. A root that comes from God. You have to be nourished so that you can be healthy in God. That you can be well. What did the woman tell the prophet about her son? Well, he asked her, she said, all is well. Because she believed the word of the Lord concerning her having a son. She knew that God was going to be faithful, Lamentations 3 and 23. In order for God to allow you to be rooted in him, come on, you have to be ready. Some of you want things and you're not ready for it. You're not ready for the millions. You're not ready for the billions. You're not ready for the zillions. Come on, God don't listen to our lip language. He listens to the heart. God knows the things that's inside of our heart that's lovely and that's wicked. He already know what you say, because when I get them, when I know what I'm going to do, and God says, yes, I know what you're going to do already in this state that you're in. But God says, let me clean you up. Why did Jesus say, oh, come to me? Come on. He wants to clean you up. You heavy and you laden, but he says, I'm going to give you rest. How are you going to give you rest? He's going to train you. He's going to teach you. If you're going to have faith, you don't need to worry. If you're going to worry, then you don't need faith. Giving yourself rest is understanding the test. Understanding what God is doing in your life, in this dispensation, and in this timing of your life, in this season of your life. Last week, we talked about a well-seasoned wrap. This week, it is a well-rooted wrap. In order to be embedded, you have to have the spirit of obedience resting on you so you can listen. I'm not talking about hearing, but I'm talking about listening. Doing what God has asked you to do, to perform and implement the things that God has asked you to implement. To go where God has told you to go. I just heard the Lord say, some of you will have new demographics. You will live in a new place. You have finished your race in this place. Jesus, God says you're going to live in a new place. Go and follow me. When things happen to you, he's bringing it back to my remembrance, the Holy Spirit. It's nourishing me. That's how I'm able to come back and tell you what was been said, because it's not me ministering. It's the Lord ministering through me. Shedding in me, my God, I thank you. I thank you, God. I thank you, God. He says the things that's happening to you, it's not the devil. If God don't want the enemy to touch you, he can't touch you one time. But if God allowed the devil to touch, you got to ask him why. So that you can learn and be trained in obedience, so that you could be embedded. You can root yourself in him. Woman of God, I'm already rooted. No, you're not. Because if you was rooted and if the water was nourishing you, then you would see the blessings of the rain falling upon you, not sometimes, but continuously. The blessings of the Lord adds no sorrow. Am I right about it? And the blessings of the Lord is supposed to run continuously in your life. No, your life won't be perfect. He'll allow some things to come in so he can train you. But in the end, you win. You got the victory. Oh, woman of God, how do I know if I'm in bed or not? Pray. Building up yourself in your most holy faith. Praying in the Holy Spirit. Those that do not have the gifting of speaking, my God, in unknown languages and speaking in your heavenly language. God has a way of getting the information to you. That's why Habakkuk 2 says, write the vision and make it plain. God will make things plain to you so that you can understand where you are in the plan. My God, I like that. You got to put that up. God will make things plain to you so that you can understand the plan that he has for your life. He says, I know the thoughts that I have towards you, Jeremiah 29:11. And they are good and not evil, and to bring you to the expected end. Come on. Some people want to say the expected end is where I'm supposed to wind up. No, the expected end is where God expects you to end. My God, from Zion, this is too much. The expected end is where he expects you to wind up. Because of your faith and because of his grace, it abounds much. I just heard him say. He says, my grace abounds much. I want you to catch it. God will make things plain to you so you can understand the plan he has for you. Jesus. The new is all about you, God. The new is all about God and what he has for us. The new is all about him. He's using you as a vessel in the new so that you can enjoy the abundant life. Why do you enjoy the abundant life? Because of your obedience. I minister this. Obedience is king. It's at the top. Because God himself is obedience. Even Jesus had to learn obedience. You learn obedience through the things that you suffer, through the trainings, the things that God allows, the trials and tribulations that he allows to test you. That's how you learn obedience. That's why some things he allowed to happen to you, so that you can know he's speaking to you. Some of you have a problem bowing, prostrating, even down in your spirit. God says, here's the great king. And all the glory belongs to him. A well-rooted rap. Why you call us a rap, Minister Javon? Because a rap, God has wrapped himself, my God, around you. He has wrapped you with his love. He's wrapped you with his forgiveness. He's wrapped you with his long-suffering. He's wrapped you, my God, with his patience, understanding, and knowledge. He's wrapped you with his anointing. He's given you the appointing for the appointment that he has for your life. You have to be well-rooted. He keep telling me. He keep coming back to the same thing. He says, let them know the things that's transpiring in your life. God says, that's me. I'm trying to get your attention. He says, that's me. Some of you all give the enemy too much credit. God says, that's me. He says, that's why I gave you a glory shot earlier to cleanse you. God says, I will expose what I will expose. God says, I will keep hitting what I will have to keep hitting. Jesus. He just told me to go to the sea. $35 seed. It's the time of new. The new unto you. God is speaking on this set. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Do you still feel the same when you hear me sing that? Here comes the glory of the Lord. Don't let the glory have a problem coming to you because of your disobedience. Don't be a son of disobedience. Listen to everything God tells you to do. And what you don't understand, say, God, I don't understand what you are saying. Give it to me plain so I can know the plain. Don't take it upon yourself. God says, I'm removing some people from your life. He says, I'm uprooting them so I can root you. Don't play with it. Don't mess with it. I like to say that. Don't play with it and don't mess with it. In other words, what I'm saying to you, don't mess with God's business. Let him do what he want to do with you. He said, I'm uprooting them so I can root you. The things that have allowed to happen to you, simple little things. The air might be out. You might catch a flat. You might have money that you need to have released and it has not released yet. That's God speaking to you. You may have a sickness that just don't want to leave. When you know Jesus is a healer, he's a balm in Gilead. This is what people like to say, well, God decided to heal them on the other side. That's not always true. You have to know the mysteries of God. When you learn the mysteries of God, you understand the ways of God. Will you ever understand him in his fullness? No, God is too big. But he'll allow you to learn what he has purposed for you to learn. The right person that talks to God can switch that person's body condition with healings in their hand. With healing in their hand. Hezekiah's life was added on because God heard him. He decided that he would answer Hezekiah. Hezekiah was getting ready to go to the open room. Am I right about it? And God extended his life because he had the right prayer. He turned his face to the wall. Am I right about it? Come on. Some of us think we know. We don't know. You will never know God in his fullness. But God will allow you to see the back of him. Come on, Moses. Come on. He'll allow you to see something in him. As you are rooted inside of him, he will reveal the mysteries of him. Some mysteries. He loved John. Am I right? John went up and saw the heavens in the book of Revelations. And the angel told him, he said, these things will not be seen. He said, I want you to go back and tell them. I want you to go back and tell what you have seen. Some people have a relationship with God that he loved David. He called David a friend. Am I right about it? Because David knew how to pray to God. Those kind of people get God's attention. Where God may be doing one thing. Now, God is a God that does not change. Come on, so we do see a change like Hezekiah. He had already changed. Come on, and we just see in the change. God is from everlasting to everlasting. I just heard him say. He says, tell them I'm from everlasting to everlasting. Before I am was, he says, I was. And my God. Jesus. God says, before there was time, I was time. God told me to ask you something. I remember my ministers a long time ago. See how the Holy Spirit was working? He's nourishing me. What time is it in your life? If you don't know the time, then you don't know where you're going. Put it up for me. What time is it? What time is it? If God asks you a question, you already know it. He already know the answer. Adam, where art thou? He knew that Adam was not in him. He knew that Adam had been disobedient. He asked Adam where he was because, come on. I heard a minister say this. It was so deep. I heard a prophetess say this. He asked Adam where he was because he was no longer inside of God. When God asks you what time it is, he already knows the time. He wants to make sure you know the time and the season and the dispensation that you are in. When God asks a question, you already know the answer. Whoa! To a person that God asks a question to. That means he's not pleased. If he asks you a question and you don't know the answer. When he asks him, where art thou? That's because Adam was no longer embedded in him. He was not a well-rooted rat. So guess what? God got mad with both of them, Eve and Adam, and he threw them out of the garden. Do you want God to throw you out? Jesus, because of disobedience? You don't fall in the hands of an angry God. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Here comes the glory of the Lord seeping in the room. That means God says, I come to cleanse you. I come to reveal the things that you're hiding. God says, this time you cannot hide. Oh, you can't hide in your pride, God says, because you will bow. Woo! Woo! This is too much. He wants us to bow. He wants us to surrender. I surrender all. I surrender all. Come on. All to Jesus. My God, Christ, our Savior. I surrender all. This has been a glorious sin. I'm getting ready to get off. This has been something on this set. A well-rooted rap. God says you can't be planted in me in any kind of way. See, people say, well, Jesus died for me and by grace I'm saved. True. But grace cannot be perverted. That's why Revelation says all liars, all adulterers, come on. It says they will go down into Hades. Jesus. Even Jesus saved those that were what? He saved those that were lost. Oh, God, this is too much. Catch this. Adam got lost. That's why he got thrown out. But before he was lost, he was found. Am I right about it? Don't get lost and wind up in hell when God has saved you, come on, by his saving grace. Woman of God, once I'm saved, I'm always saved. Oh, yeah? You ever watch that movie, Left Behind? The pastor went to hell. Am I right about it? And he had accepted the Lord as his personal savior. He went to hell for lying. He went to hell for lying. Once you become saved, stay saved. When Adam was blessed, he named all of the creation. He didn't stay in the blessing. He got lost and God threw him out. And he became naked. Why, Jesus, God preaching this thing. Why was he naked? Because God had to expose him. That's why he said, who told you was naked? Being naked is allowing the world to see the true you. This word will preach to the nations. Jesus. God says, to let you know, I have a second segment on this message. This is a good message. A well-rooted rap. I got to get off. Adam was naked. He was exposed
because of his disobedience. But long as he was inside of God, the Lord hid him. He was so good that God took a rib and made one man out of man. What did Jesus tell Martha? He says, Mary has, my God has taken the good. She has taken the piece of the good piece. He said, it will not be taken from her. Jesus. God says, grab hold to the good part. That you will be rooted well. That you will be nourished well. That you will not be lost but found inside of him. That you would grow into the newness that he is calling you to. Jesus. God said, that's the end of the message. That's it. Sow your $35 seed. It's a new beginning seed. Why is it a new beginning seed? Because you have allowed the glory to seep upon you. And you have told God that, you know what, God cleansed me and washed me with hyssop. See, I don't want this thing inside of me. It don't belong. I want to serve you. Not only do I want to serve you, God, I want to surrender. I surrender all. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Let it seep in your room. Seeping in the room. Let it cleanse you. Let it expose you. God, he loves you with an everlasting love. Sow your $35 seed. It will meet your need. It's a cleansing. It's a glory shot. I love you. Be a well-rooted rat. God bless you.
Quarantine to always being on the scene. Selah Productions Incorporated has birthed Selah Spot, and it is hot, hot, hot. Flaming hot with the Holy Ghost fire as Minister Javon Ophelia Butler brings the word from the four winds of God of the third dimension, the place where God lives, pulling down the kavod, God's Shekinah glory. Introducing Selah Spot, the virtual view, God's view about you. Boxing the devil through prayer. Prayer is your only weapon. God's mercies renewed every morning. Join us for fire, straight down from heaven, as we go to war through prayer with Selah Serenity Prayer Line with Minister Javon Ophelia Butler. Dial in at 857-347-0610 or stream live from Selah Serenity Prayer Line on Facebook. For prayer requests, send your email to selahprayerline@gmail.com. Moving the nations through prayer and Selah Spot, the virtual view. Catch the wave and join the movement. Like us now.
All things, Romans 8:28. For your good, harden not your heart. And allow your heart to say yes to the spirit of obedience. The Lord is calling his nation down to its knees. Stop praying, heal the land, and ask God to heal you so that you can heal the land. God bless you.
Fresh wind blowing is fresh wind blowing is fresh. Fresh wind blowing in this room. Holy Ghost fire.